carrying the fire pump to the workplace, and its installation. This section includes factors that installers and authorized service technicians must consider. Aetna fire pumps are designed and packaged as modules that can be easily assembled and handled. Our products must be carried from the delivery vehicle to the assembly site without damage using a forklift truck or lifting slings. If the product is mishandled without the proper handling lifting equipment, the sensitive pump coupling settings can be damaged. Open the packaging of the collector module and the electrical diesel module at the assembly site. Ensure all parts of the product checked in the material delivery sheets contained in the manual supplied with the fire pumps are indeed in the packaging. If there are any missing parts, report them to the customer and tell them that the device will be commissioned once the missing parts are delivered. Assembling of the fire pump. Make sure the surface upon which the fire pump is placed is smooth and flat. First, set the pilot module and then the other module by aligning the space between them to the connecting bolts on the pressure collector. If there is a diesel engine pump beside electrical driven pump, first connect the compensator section on the pressure collector to the pump outlet to prevent vibration caused by diesel engine in the diesel modules, then install the pressure collector onto the modules and fasten the bolts. Install the flex hose on the pilot pump to the appropriate inlet on the pressure collector. In NFPA models, connect the eccentric suction kit to the suction port of the pump, then connect the butterfly or gate valve, and then connect the suction pipe individually to the suction pipe from the water reservoir. If there is a diesel pump, first mount the compensator, the eccentric suction kit, and then the butterfly or gate valve to the suction port of the pump in diesel models. Connect the pilot pump inlet to the port on the suction collector by hose. The suction collector in NFPA complying fire pumps is optional. Mount the suction kit and gate valve to the suction port of the pump in EN12845 models. Mount the compensator, suction kit and butterfly and or gate valve to the suction port of the pump on the diesel modules. EN12845 models are not supplied with suction manifold as it is recommended that EN norm pumps should prime the water independently. Connect the outlet flexible hose on the pilot pump to the inlet on the pressure manifold. Remember to use gasket between the connections. Connect the flexible hose to 1-inch coupling on the pressure manifold and the other end to the expansion tank inlet coupling. Before tightly fixing pressure and suction manifolds, tightly mount the frames to the floor by steel dowels and then finish the complete assembling tightly. There should be enough space around the location of the fire pump to allow authorized services and technician interventions. Vents should be placed to allow the inflow of clean and cool air from the bottom and outflow of warmed air from the top of the wall or door in fire groups with a diesel engine. Install steel flex pipe to the exhaust outlet on the diesel module. Toxic gas discharged from this outlet should be transferred outside before releasing it into the environment. If the steel flex pipe is long, then use a larger diameter steel flex. Ensure that the exhaust pipe discharges exhaust gases outside and tell the customer or technician responsible for the fire pump that otherwise those in the immediate vicinity may suffer a serious health risk. Fill the fuel tank on the diesel module with diesel fuel. Check if there is enough water in the water cooling radiator of the diesel engine. Check the oil level of the diesel engine with a bayonet gauge. Oil levels must be between minimum and maximum level indicator. Return to the reservoir tank is enabled by connecting a hose with an 8mm outer radius to the outlets right below the non-return valve. The goal of this hose is to discharge heater water and to prevent overheating of the mechanical seal, since the system is tested with a closed valve, and to provide the air bleeding during pump priming. Do not install the fire pump outdoors. Instead, place it in an area that does not get colder than 4 degrees Celsius for electric and 10 degrees Celsius for diesel modules, and ensure that it will not be affected by external weather conditions and frost. Otherwise, the water in the pumps may freeze and cause the pumps to crack. Better still, place the pump in a properly built indoor fire room that has a water sprinkler system.